We call this region the Sky Island region. For me personally, what I love about this area of the Arizona-Sonoran borderlands is the incredible biological diversity. It's not the same as walking into a rainforest. You have to look a little closer at what's happening. You have to try and seek out a lot of the fauna and the cool flowers and seek them under bushes and find them under creosotes and under mesquites. I didn't know anything about bats until I started working with Bat Conservation International. I knew bats ate insects, I knew a few things, but with this particular project that we're working on with bats and agaves, it's extremely fun, beautiful, sexy story because you have these agaves that are so well known. Agaves in the Southwest and in Mexico are the beautiful, charismatic plant. 90% of the genus is monocarpic, which means that it only flowers once in its lifetime. They live for decades. And as they're living, as they're growing, they're just filling up with sugar. And the reason to do that is to flower. They put up these huge stalks with just tubes of sugar that then go into these palmate flowers for the bat. But what the agave is trying to do is attract a pollinator that can fly a long distance.
So the really cool thing about these bats, these nectar bats, is that they're flying all the way from central Mexico all the way to the southwest US. It's over 700 miles that they're migrating every year. And the crazy thing is that it's mostly the females, the pregnant females, that make this migration.
This bat is putting all this energy into having one pup a year. And the agave plant puts every ounce of energy into its ultimate flowering to attract bats. And so it's this really excellent relationship that's formed where the bat is able to take the pollen to all these different agaves, taking in all the genetics and everything that those individual agaves have learned to make that plant more resilient in the landscape.
They need agaves as an important food source to fuel that migration and to successfully raise their babies. And so we're working to restore agaves across a really large binational landscape to connect the migratory corridor of the bats, but also work with people to support their livelihoods.
Bueno, históricamente los agaves han sido una de las especies etnobotánicas más importantes en la historia de nuestro país y en la historia del noreste mexicano. Las comunidades actualmente están visualizando a los agaves como un elemento que puede ser muy importante para la recuperación de los suelos. También pueden obtener forraje para su ganado y también puede ser un elemento del cual pueden obtener productos como el aguamiel, pulque, y el mezcal pudiera ser, ¿no? Los agaves son idóneos para iniciar actividades de restauración de suelos y iniciar cadenas productivas a partir de su aprovechamiento y manejo de su territorio.
Leptonycteris nivalis, it's considered endangered. In the last 30 years, the population has declined around 50%. We have records from the 80s where roosts used to have 10,000 animals, and now some of those roosts are empty. We haven't been able to find the species anymore. We all depend on the services that nature provides, and some of those are provided by bats. Just because you don't see it, it doesn't mean that we don't need them. It affects all of us.
The wild agaves are absolutely dependent on these bats, and so many other things use the agave flowers. So the bats really are kind of what we call a keystone. If you didn't have the bats, there would be a lot of unraveling of that ecosystem.
We really don't have too much time to act. Bats take a long time to rebound. Agaves take a long time to grow, 5 to 10 years or more, to flower and feed the bats. So we work with partners to collect native agave seeds. We grow those seeds in nurseries, and then we plant them back out on the landscape to provide these food patches for the bats, and also areas of agaves where people can use them. We also work with local partners to provide training in sustainable agriculture and ranching practices to create a sustainable, resilient landscape long into the future. The work that Bat Conservation International is doing is really focused on not just bats, but the landscapes, the people, the ecosystems. It's a holistic view. You have to think big picture and really work together to achieve that.